Welcome to Serrano, soon to be Seahawks. Now, normally in a regular year, you would have already been here at Serrano. You would have been visiting in our gym for a tour, for an assembly, to get to know the school, to get to know me and our staff here. And due to the unusual year we've been having, we haven't been able to do that. So we're going to bring that information to you. So you very well likely may have already taken a virtual tour with one of our ASB students. If not, you'll get to do that this week. And this elective registration form that you're now going through, you would have had an opportunity to talk with us about it, and we would have shared some things with you. But we're doing that all right here virtually, so you have everything that you need. Now, I want to share with you a few particulars about the elective registration process, and specifically our STEAM elective. Now, STEAM, our STEAM Village is a limited availability program, meaning there are a certain number of students that we can take into the program. So if you really want STEAM Village, make sure you select it as your first choice. That way it gives you the best chance to get into the STEAM Village if you really want it. But before you make that selection, I want you to know a couple of other things. First of all, STEAM Village is a two-year commitment. We're asking you to select it as your elective choice for the next 2 years. You will have three electives as a seventh grader and then three electives as an eighth grader, 12 weeks each rotating through the year. You'll have in seventh grade, you'll have engineering, computer science, and digital media arts in an introductory way. And then in eighth grade, you'll get all of those courses again in more depth. So you'll have those six elective classes as you go through Serrano here. Now, also, I want you to know that if you are interested in STEAM Village, that there is an application that you need to fill out, and you're going to get more information on that in just a moment. In addition to that, I want you to know if you're interested in the STEAM Village and you would like to take another elective, such as band, maybe you're a musician and you don't want to give up band for STEAM Village, we are going to offer a zero period option, which gives you the opportunity to have two electives in your seventh grade year and possibly in your eighth grade year as well. But for seventh grade, we've never done it before, and you'll have the opportunity to select that you would like a zero period elective. Now, with that, you also need to know a few things. If you choose the zero period, you have to realize that school is going to start for you at 7:15 a.m. every day, all year. So if you're not a morning person, you want to think that through. So zero period elective gives you the opportunity to have those two electives. Also with zero period, once you are selected for a zero period, you are committing to keeping that elective all year long. You can't drop out because we staff that class at the initial ratio of students to teachers. So you need to stay there. It's a commitment for all year. And one thing I do want to let you know, there is no guarantee that we can offer a zero period because it depends on you. If we get enough demand, meaning enough students want a zero period, then we'll be able to offer it. If we don't get enough students that would like a zero period, then we can't offer it. So information will be given to you at the end of summer to let you know if you were selected for that. So now you want to know more about the elective choices you have. So I'm going to turn this over to our seventh grade assistant principal, Ms. Branley. So take it away, Ms. Branley.
Hello, future Seahawks. I am Ms. Branley, your seventh grade assistant principal. We can't wait to have you join us next year on campus. To make next year super successful, we need some more information from you. We need to know what electives you'd like to take next year. So I'm going to walk you through this form and walk you through what your options are, where you can find out some more information about that, and how you can let us know what your first, second, third, and fourth choice is going to be. At Serrano, you've got an option of a year-long elective or a trimester elective. If you choose a trimester elective, that means that you're going to be getting three different electives throughout the course of the year. If you choose a year-long option like band or ASB, that means that you'll have that elective all year long. Within the form, there are course descriptions of each of the electives, and you can find those by clicking on this link. And there is also a video that you're going to want to check out where you can find out more information about each elective option, the types of work that you'll be doing, and what you can expect from each of those classes. Once you've checked out that information and you've decided what electives you would like to choose, you'll do that in this portion of the form. You'll choose your first, second, third, and fourth choice, letting us know what electives you'd like and what order you'd prefer those in.
Thanks, Seahawks, for taking the time to make your elective choices. We can't wait to have you on campus next year.
Thank you, Mr. Young, and thank you, Ms. Brownlee, for all that information. Just a quick reminder, Seahawks, for the ASB, AVID, and the STEAM Village, you must fill out an application if you are interested in that elective. Only those students who fill out the application will be considered for the class. Lastly, if you have any further questions or need clarification, do not hesitate to contact Ms. Blake, our 7th grade counselor, or Ms. Bean, our 8th grade counselor, at the email provided. As everyone has already said a couple of times, we can't wait to see you next year.